There's a lot that we don't know about the nature of those experiences. There's a little bit known about the immediate effects of psilocybin. Certainly we know that psilocybin binds serotonin 2A. We know, you know, different areas of brains that are activated and deactivated. We know something about the default mode network.
I wanted to ask you about that. Yeah, it's very interesting.
Yeah. And so work from the UK additional work now is showing that at least acutely psilocybin appears to decrease activity within the default mode network.
And is that so from my understanding, because I don't know much about this, and this is all from neuroimaging studies you're talking about, psilocybin, the default mode network, is that something that's active like when you're ruminating on something, like when you're thinking about something that you sort of, you know, rumination, which is associated with depression, ruminating on the future or the past? Or
exactly.
That's it, right?
Yeah, that's it. And so activity in the default mode network is actually increased in depression. And here, you know, a couple of the hubs are prefrontal cortex and posterior cingulate. And the connectivity and activity in those regions are decreased. Now, the interesting thing about the default mode network is it is associated with rumination. It's sometimes thought to be responsible for what's called self-referential processing. Ideas that relate to a sense of self, you know, and that's kind of what rumination is. Woe is me.
Right.
Yeah. But and so that's increased in depression. And interestingly, activity in the default mode network is decreased in long-term meditators.
So. Oh, that's interesting.
Yes. Yeah. And that fits, if you think about it, with this whole story about, you know, goals of meditation being to bring you into the present moment, to drop the ego, you know, to surrender a sense of self, if you will. Okay. And so the curious thing now is that psilocybin looks very much like meditation in that regard. So there's decreases in the default mode network. And that kind of fits with this story we can tell in terms of the phenomenology, that one thing that people are encouraged to do when they have these experiences is surrender a sense of egoic holding. That is, kind of get out of the way of the experience and just be present in the present moment. One of the qualities of that experience where you get out of past and future, and you're present, and you're present in a way that untangles you from this hell sense of self and constraining. But these, of course, are all kind of words. We don't have they're descriptive ways putting a framework around psychological processes, you know, but they fall short of kind of the empirical hard science that we would like to have. So it's kind of frustrating.
Right.
We're dealing a lot in metaphor at this point in terms of a descriptive framework for how these experiences might affect people.